The Lightroom Classic Map module is one of my favorite modules because it allows you to visualize where you took your photos and give that nostalgic experience to your photograph journey. So in this tutorial, you're going to learn how to use the Map module as well as add GPS coordinates to your photos. So let's get started. So right now I'm in the Map module and you can see the GPS coordinates right here. I'm on the location preset, but if you're on the default preset, you'll also see the GPS coordinates right here. But I'll go back to the location preset and just move over to the library module for a second, and you can see the GPS coordinates here as well. If you don't see them, click on Customize, scroll down to Camera Info, and just make sure GPS coordinates are marked or checked. I'll just click on Done. So this photo right here, and here's the film strip on the thumbnail. You can see it has the GPS coordinates because there's an icon right here which looks like a quote box. So if I go to the Map module, and this photo right here I took in Lake Louise, Alberta, you can see it's preloaded or pre-populated with the information. Even though it says Lake Louise is the town nearby, which is right, where is it? That's a long road to the lake I took. So here is Lake Louise, and this is where I took the photo, but the photo is actually of Lake Moraine. So if I click on this icon right here, it's actually Lake Moraine. So I can put in the sublocation of Lake Moraine if I want. But once I do that, this information will be gone. So if I click on another photo and go back to this photo, you can see Lake Moraine is here, but now the other information or the other location information is gone. So I'll need to pre-populate that again and put Alberta there. Okay, so that looks a little bit better. So now going back to this photo right here, I can zoom in and zoom out of the map. I can also press the plus or minus sign, the keyboard shortcuts to zoom in and zoom out. I'm going to center it right here by clicking on the thumbnail. And then I can visualize the map differently if I want to. So the map style, there's hybrid, then there's the standard Google or Apple Maps view, there's the satellite, terrain, and then there's the light and dark options. But I prefer sticking with hybrid. And if you want to see more information on the map as well as some of the establishments around the photo, you can click on Show More Labels. And that's it right there. So you can see it looks a little bit more like Google Maps with the labeling. Now there's this option right here, Load Track Log. That's if you took your photos with a third party or another device and you want to load the GPS coordinates onto Lightroom Classic and then manually assign the GPS coordinates to your photos. So the best thing to do is when you are taking photos with GPS coordinates, make sure it is enabled and make sure you have a GPS enabled camera. And if you don't, I'll show you how to add GPS coordinates to your photo in a second. So now I'm going to move over to a different photo, which is right here on this thumbnail. And you can see not all of these photos have GPS coordinates. So I can click on Tagged, and it'll only show you the photos right here that have GPS coordinates. The other photos, they don't have GPS coordinates. So these are the untagged, and this is the visible on the map. So this is the only photo that's on the map that I can see right now. So just going to this tagged photo right here, you can see this is actually a photo of Patagonia. Actually, you may not notice that unless you've been there already, but I'm just going to zoom out, and this is Patagonia right here, all this region right here. So I'm just going to zoom back in. Now I'm going to show you how to add GPS coordinates to your photos. So I'll go to untagged right here. And these photos right here, I'll just go to the library module and show them to you. These photos right here, they were all taken in Patagonia as well at Mount Fitzroy. It's the same logo of the Patagonia clothing brand. So in order to add GPS coordinates to these photos, I'm just going to go click on none right here, and then I'm going to search on the map. I'm going to go to Mount Fitzroy. Hopefully it finds it. So it's right here, Fitzroy. I'm just going to zoom in. I'm going to try to figure out where I took this photo exactly, try to give it a better idea. So this is Mount Fitzroy. You can see there's this dot right here. So this is the location that I searched. And if you don't see the legend here, you can go to your menu bar at the top, go to view, and then go to show map key. So it'll show you the legend. So this is the search result right here. And you can see it's trying to populate a photo, but it doesn't look like it worked. But anyways, I'm gonna try to go and find the viewpoint of where I took the photo. It's probably here. No, this is the mountain. And let me see here where I took the photo. I think I took the photo around right here, maybe, of Mount Fitzroy, because I remember there was a lake in front of it when I took the photo. Anyways, for this demonstration purpose, it does not matter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on these photos right here. Actually, I'll go to the map module, go back to it, click on these photos here, and then shift click on these other photos. So this is a panoramic or stitching photo I took. And then I'm going to command click or control click on the map right here. And now you can see these six photos have GPS coordinates right here. And now you can see there's this number here, which just means it's a group of photos. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Make sure I click on the photo to make sure I'm zoomed in and centered. And that's where roughly I took the photo. But if I click on the thumbnail here, you can see it. The GPS coordinates are added. And if I want to remove the GPS coordinates, I can just click on here and press delete, and it'll give the option to delete one or delete all selected. So that's how you add GPS coordinates to your photos. And I'll show you another example. I can click on this photo right here. I'll go to the library module. This is the stitched photo that I took with the panoramic merging I did in Lightroom Classic. I'll go to the map module again. I'll just zoom in a little bit better. Let me see if I can find that lake. I think it's this lake I took the photo in front of. Anyways, I'll click on this photo and then I can drag it right here to the map. And now it's been added, so you can see. So the best thing to do with the map module is try to use a camera enabled or GPS enabled camera to make it easier. If you don't have that, it's not a big deal. You can manually add it, but to save time, it's better to have a GPS enabled camera. And if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and check out my photography on Instagram. And as always, live easy, sleep breezy, and stay lovely.